die creëren wildtuinse wilde honden. Ons het hulle allemaal baie goed leer ken die afgelopen paar jaar hier op 5050. Die jagtrop op die H3 nabij Afsal. Die berg- en daltrop wat gereeld op hulle tochte buiten die park in strikke verstrengel raak. Die Pretoria koptrop waar die genietkoppies nabij die ruskamp deurswerf. En natuurlijk is Kokoza trop met sy legendarische Alpha Reen Lightning. Die laatste keer wat ons by die honde ingeloer het, was toe die alfa deef van die Pretoria koptrop een nekband gekry het. Want sy is baie slim. Sy het haar leeplek hoog bo in die genietkoppies gemaak. So Grant Beverly, die veldnavorser vir die Trust vir die Bedreigde Natuurlewe se wilde honde projek, kon nog nie haar nekband data aflaai nie. Maar die klein hondjies is op die been en blijkbaar al verskeie kere gesien. So ek is hier om te kyk of ons hierdie trop kan opspoor.
Vehicle, which I've spent so much time in with you.
Oh, indeed, searching for dogs, eh? That's what I do every day.
What has changed with the Pretoria School pack since the last time I was here?
Quite a lot's happened to the pack since you were last here 2 years ago. In fact, they've had two very successful denning seasons and they increased in number. Obviously, when we first saw them at the kopje at Pretoria School, it was quite a small pack with only a few adults. Unfortunately, since then, a number of individuals have been killed and it's a small pack again with only a few adults and their pups. So it's quite a difficult pack to find, and I haven't actually seen the pack in a couple of weeks, although I did get a report of the alpha female with the collar about a week ago. So hopefully if we head out to Pretoria School today, we'll be able to find them.
Die ochend is al 'n paar uur uit, maar geen geluk by die ou leeplek nie. Niks inligting van die nekband nie en ook nie 'n enkele waarneming is aan Grant gerapporteer nie. Ons het besluit om by die Jack Safari Lodge naby Afsal te gaan inloer. Hier het ek 2 jaar gelede in die Biamiti rivierloop gehelp om nekbande aan 2 van hierdie trop se wyfies te sit. Maar die dag het nie verbeter nie. 'N dooie hond en geen skynbare oorsaak van dood nie. Niks bene nie, net hare. Dit kan een van die wyfies met die nekband wees. Daarom het Grant van die hare bymekaar gemaak om die hond deur middel van die DNS-monsters wat ons 2 jaar gelede geneem het, te identifiseer. Dit was 'n lang rit terug Skukuza toe, maar ek ken ook al teen hierdie tyd die Kreerwildtuin honde. En terwyl ons inry, honde. En soos altyd, 'n nuwe trop wat ek nog nie van tevore teëgekom het nie. Dit was die Toulon-trop wat in die Sabi Sands omgewing bly en soms in die Skukuza area kom jag. Hierdie uitbundige jongelinge was slegs 'n paar maande gelede nog kleintjies en ek moes net die leefplek sien waar hulle groot geword het. Daarom was 'n besoek aan Koopmans kamp in orde en 'n veldgids het ons na die verlate leefplek vergesel.
So the puppies were here a couple of months ago.
Yeah, exactly. So this is actually one of their dens that they had visited while they were denning. And it, as you can see, it's probably one of the perfect locations for a den site, with thick vegetation for protection on this side. And this open area here in front of the den, the pups are coming down and playing all over this open area while the adults were lying around resting. So it's one of the perfect spots for them, you know. There's opportunity for them to go hunt out in all directions. Perfect location for their den.
Now, denning season must be one of the most exciting times in the year for a wild dog researcher.
It is, and one of the fortunate things for denning season is if you do find a pack denning, they're going to stay in the same place or at least in the same area for 3 months. You know, so you've got the opportunity to go back there and see them more frequently. But then if they're denning in an area where the den is inaccessible, then you don't see the pack for 3 months. Like the Orphan pack, for example, who denned in a wilderness area that's over 100,000 hectares, and I haven't seen that pack for over 4 months.
Now, I know it's got nothing to do with this specific pack, but I have to ask you, Lightning, what has he been up to? Because he's such a popular character actually around the world.
He is a popular character, and believe it or not, his pack has had pups again this year. Wow. So the numbers have increased slightly since last year, and he's still going strong. So Lightning still has it.
Not giving up.
No.
Are you optimistic that these pups will get to see adulthood?
Unfortunately, not really. Pup survival rates in Kruger is really low, and already with this pack, they had 9 pups this season, and 5 have been killed. And the unfortunate thing is we don't even know what's killed those 5 pups. We suspect it to be lions, and a few weeks before the pack started denning, the alpha male was actually killed by a lion in the riverbed, not so far from here. So we suspect that those 5 pups were most likely killed by lions as well. So from 9 to 4 already, it's quite a high death rate of the pups. So hopefully they do make it to adulthood, but the reality is that there's no guarantees.
Jy kan jouself net voorstel, hierdie klein warm lyfies, styf het binnen toegewikkel in die aand, en dan sodra die son opkom, mate, dan is dit uit die bo oor die termiethoop speelerig, natuurlik besig om hulle self en hulle oppassers totaal en al uit te put.
Hierdie relatief klein troppie het in my 9 kleintjies gekry. Moeilik om te glo dat die honde wat ek vroeër in die pad sien hardloop het, net 6 maande gelede so klein was. Grant het my vertel dat die afgelope teelseisoen die suksesvolste in die Kruiwiltuin se onlangse geskiedenis was. 100 hondjies hierdie jaar gebore. Nou op die drempel van volwassenheid en besig om hulle weg vorentoe te vind.
Het was 'n absolute belewenis om die afgelope paar jaar die Kruiwiltuin se wilde honde te kon dokumenteer. Ek onthou die eerste keer wat ek tyd saam met Grant in sy navorsingsvoertuig spandeer het, was al net meer as 100 wilde honde in die hele park. Maar soos ek vandag hier sit, in die middel van hierdie klein stukkie juweel van ons land, kan ek met sekerheid sê dat daardie getal gegroei het en staan ons nou op naaste by 250 wilde honde.